Hi everyone, in this video we look at how a toilet flush valve works. This will help troubleshoot problems. Let's get going. First, let's look at the parts of the flush valve. This is the entire flush valve. And here is the handle that is attached to the lever, which is attached to the flapper by a chain between the lever and flapper. As just mentioned, this is the flapper. And this is the flush valve seat. Here is the gasket that makes a watertight seal between the flush valve and the toilet tank. The lock nut that secures the flush valve to the toilet tank. And finally, the overflow pipe. Now let's look at how the flush valve works. Water sits in the tank waiting for the next flush. Pressing the handle down lifts the lever, which lifts the flapper. Now the water in the tank rushes out of the tank, through the valve, and down to the toilet bowl. Air in the flapper helps it float, and the flapper lowers as the water level drops, and eventually falls to close the valve. The flapper and the valve seat form a watertight seal, and water from the fill valve slowly refills the tank, until the water reaches a predetermined level that is normally 1/2 to 1 inch below the top of the overflow pipe. The overflow pipe serves two purposes. First, it will prevent a flood if the fill valve fails to close. The rising water will overflow into and down the pipe, through the valve, and into the bowl. The overflow pipe's second purpose is to refill the bowl. Water from the fill valve flows through the refill tube, into and down the overflow pipe, through the valve, and into the bowl. This is part 2 of a 3-part series. Part 1 looked at the toilet bowl, and part 3 looks at the fill valve. Links are in the description below. Here's another video that you might be interested in.